Well, howdy YouTube family. It is Bolt CRNA coming to you again with another day's topic. Sorry, I hit the camera. So I just got done recording with Annual Congress, the demystifying SRNA to CRNA session. So I'm in my suit and tie, all prepped up and ready. And I thought today is gonna be a good day to talk about this hot new topic, the rebranding of the AANA that they just announced yesterday. They are now the American Association of Nurse Anesthesiology instead of Nurse Anesthetists. So there's been a lot of hot debate and topic about this online, and I even polled a bunch of you guys on my Instagram since so many of you were commenting on it. I asked you what you wanted to know about it and what your thoughts were on the new change. So today we're going to talk more about that. Let's get into it. So I want to preface this by saying that this change has actually been in the works since over a year ago. This was in discussion about 2 years ago, and then over the 2019 or so time period, they started formulating all this data and started to look at this more, you know, critically. And then a bunch of CRNAs brought the idea together as an amendment and brought it forward to the annual business meeting of 2020 in August of 2020. And it was discussed and voted on then by the CRNA members of the organization. And it was an overwhelming percentage of people said, yes, we want this change, we want this to happen. So it's actually been an entire year since this was already ruled into process and happening, but we really didn't talk much about it back then because they were doing a lot of market research, they were having to figure out how to do the rebranding and all the details. When you're talking about a massive organization that represents 60,000 anesthesia experts on, you know, in the America, they don't do things quickly. They do things with a very slow process. They look at legal matters, they look at all that kind of stuff. So it took them an entire year, and then they decided to announce it and launch it yesterday. And I was actually in one of the promo videos. They approached me about being in like a little clip from the promo video. So if you go on my Instagram, if you don't follow me on Instagram, what are you doing? Go follow me over there, Bolt CRNA. I'm very active over there pretty much every day. And I posted the promo video over there with me in it. So if you wanna see that, go see that. And it also gives a good background. The promo video gives great background to like the history of CRNAs, how we've been around for over a century, how we progressed from certain names to certain things and certain titles and educational landmarks throughout the, you know, 100 years or whatever. So that gives a lot of good context to the situation. Another thing that I like to make note here is that by them changing their name, this does not mean that you're obligated to use any kind of certain new descriptor or name. It just means this is the name that they're going forward with. The national organization that represents all of us, this is the name they're choosing to go forward with. If you prefer the word nurse anesthetist and you don't like the word anesthesiology at all, you certainly don't have to use that word. That is a descriptor, and it's a term that we're going forward with. Most of us like it. If you don't, you are totally free to use whatever other terms you want. That's within, you can go to the ANA's website and they'll tell you the appropriate descriptors for a CRNA that are you know, appropriate and legal. And then they'll tell you what you can use. And there's a handful of different things you can call yourself. So go over there, check that out, and you can use any of those that you like. Now, into the meat of this, I got a lot of comments from you guys, so I thought, all right, let me just put a little question box on there and Q&A type thing and figure out what it is you wanna know, what you think about. And there's a lot of different random things said here. So let's start. G. Macharg says, they think it's the start of CRNA progression in September. They wait to see how they refer to us or stand. Okay, so this is the person who's starting a CRNA program. He's curious when he starts his program in September if he is going to have to change the way he refers to himself. No, your university is pretty much going to tell you the way that they like to use their nomenclature. You're not licensed. I mean, you're a licensed RN when you're in training, but you're not licensed as a CRNA in training, so you're not going to refer to yourself as a licensed provider at that point anyway when you're in training. So yeah, your university gives an idea of what they prefer. And there's lots of different names for people in training, in nurse anesthesia training. Some people call them nurse anesthesia residents, NARS, which is what my university hospital system calls nurse anesthesia residents, NARS. They are also called resident registered nurse anesthetist, RRNAs, and some people call them SRNAs, student registered nurse anesthetist. So those are all common terms that you'll hear. Tyler Christopher says, maybe how to navigate MDs that may bring this up to NARS in clinical. So this is a good question. If this is brought up to you by a physician when you're in your training, avoid talking about it. I mean, you can just simply say, I don't feel comfortable discussing this, or I don't know. This is not a topic that you want to discuss when you're in training, because these topics are mired in politics and they can be landmines for you in training. So I would just say, this is not something that's, when you're in training and you're at the hospital rotating and learning and growing as a clinician, your job is to, you know, focus on the anesthesia and the patient and all of this extra outside, what we call ourselves, what we don't call ourselves, our professional organizations, legal things that are being done and passed in the back end with DC and PAC money and all that stuff. That is something that you will discuss outside of the hospital setting, that you will be involved in the classroom setting, or when you go to national organization meetings, or you go to DC to talk to legislators, then you're involved in that kind of stuff, but it is not appropriate to discuss it at work. And that pretty much goes for even when you're practicing as a CRNA or a physician anesthesiologist. These are not things that are appropriate to bring up in the workplace. Shelby Liana says, I love the idea. Do you think it will receive any pushback from physicians? Possibly. She also says, I don't think they'll be thrilled that CRNAs will share a title with them since we don't share. That's kind of true, that there is a subsect of physicians online that I can tell. Of course, I've never spoken to any of them in person about this, but online there seems to be a vocal, at least medical students and residents that I can tell, that do not like to share any kind of titles or any kind of, anything with CRNAs. There seems to be a very anti-advanced practice provider or non-physician provider sentiment amongst the med student and resident group in online forums. And so anytime a topic comes up like this that's, you know, progress for us or new things for us that they feel like infringes on them, they are very vocal about that. So yeah, you're right, they probably won't like it, but, Our role as anesthesia professionals is not to please everyone else who's also anesthesia professionals, or maybe not even in anesthesia at all. So you can't please everybody. So you really have to do what's right for you and what's right for the patients. Katarina says, have you introduced yourself as I'll be your anesthesia provider to your patients to cut confusion? No, I don't do this. And this was actually taught to us in training. Never come into a room and say, I'm your anesthesia provider today, unless you specifically then say that you are a CRNA and you explain your role. The reason why is because there you can either be a physician anesthesiologist or a CRNA. And if you just say, I'm your anesthesia provider, it purposefully leaves it so vague, they don't know who you are. And I don't like that. I like my patients to know exactly who I am, because I want them to credit their great anesthesia care to me, a CRNA. I don't want them to go away, which happens all the time. Patients will go away and be like, oh, my anesthesiologist was great today, and they'll be talking about me. And I'll have to specify, like, you mean nurse anesthesiologist, correct? Or you mean your CRNA, correct? Because I'm a CRNA. You know, I don't want someone else to get the credit for what I'm doing. So I never say I'm your anesthesia provider and leave it vague. Anna Reese says, that physician anesthesiologist will be mad, but it will help patients. Yeah, so there's a general theme here that a lot of the nurses and students in training are worried about the other people in the anesthesia world not liking the progress and change, which I guess historically there's always been backlash from any time there's been progress with CRNA. So that makes sense that they would anticipate that. NVR Romero says, it's basically to not confuse patients, right? We can even say anesthetist. Oh wait, it says it's basically to not confuse patients, right? Who can even say anesthetist correctly? So he's saying most people don't understand the word anesthetist or can even say the word anesthetist. So this is a more clear way of explaining yourself to patients. And now remember, this is the AANA rebranding their last word from anesthetist to anesthesiology. It doesn't mean, in 2 years ago, they voted on the fact that nurse anesthesiologist is an appropriate descriptor, but it doesn't mean that they're saying that everyone has to refer to themselves as a nurse anesthesiologist now. That it is a descriptor, it has been for 2 years, voted on 2 years ago by the AANA as an appropriate descriptor, but you definitely can refer to yourself as a nurse anesthetist if you want to, and them rebranding their overall name doesn't mean that they're telling everyone they have to do this. So do what you feel is right for you and your practice and your state, and always be very clear when you're discussing who you are with a patient, exactly who you are. MK Merritt for Eva says, well, it's about time. And praise hands. Richard says, love it. Anna says, very appropriate since ology comes from the Greek word logia, the study of something. And MDs may own their licenses, but they don't own the word anesthesiology. That's true. They actually rebranded years ago to the phrase physician anesthesiologist many years ago because they actually did their own studies with patients and they found from their own studies that most patients don't understand the word anesthesiologist means physician. So they said, you need to start saying physician anesthesiologist. And there's dental anesthesiologist, there's veterinarian anesthesiologist. There's lots of different fields and people who practice anesthesia in different areas. I think people get so tied up between CRNAs and physicians, you know, in this kind of like battle between us because we do work together so frequently. So people are a little bit more heated to want to fight about it. But honestly, it's not a term that's exclusive to physicians. Renzi Tree says, very interesting from a UK perspective, can be confused, but overall utmost respect. So in the UK, actually, they don't. There are no such thing as CRNAs there. They don't have CRNAs in the UK, and their physician, the people who go to medical school there, their medical school training and their whole training is just totally different there from America. But when they do med school and go into their training to do anesthesia, they're actually called anesthetists essentially, which is honestly where the word for us came from. Over 100 years ago when we started calling ourselves that because it's like an old British word. It means, you know, like the provider of anesthesia. So the UK actually still uses that term for their physicians. So physician anesthesiologists are actually called anesthetists in the UK. Natalia Dodoro says, wouldn't want to call it anything else. Lamborghini Mercy says, finally coming out of caveman years. Goompick 12 says, stirring the pot, but because the ASA is trying to undermine the whole profession. I would say it's not about, I mean, the ANA is not interested in infighting with anybody else in any other professional organization. We hate to see other organizations target and fight with us, but it would be great if we could all get along. But I would say it's about just progressing what we feel is appropriate for us. Beaumont says, intentionally confusing for patients. There were a subsect of med students and residents who commented that they just do not like this and they feel it's confusing for patients and they will not see it any other different way, no matter what rationale you give. So that is a real, you know, area of concern for them. Laura Kay says, couldn't be happier. This is a much needed change in our professional benefit. I agree, Laura. I think it's going to be a great change. And I think we've progressed so much in the last couple decades. And I think we're going to continue progressing. It seems that that's what is going to be needed for our healthcare system and our patients. So looking forward to the positive change. Well, all right, guys, that was everything on the new rebranding and name change that you guys had to say. And I want to hear from you below what you think. Do you like it? Do you not like it? I'm sure it's a polarizing topic, so there'll be discussion below. Remember, if we get into discussion, it needs to remain professional and it needs to remain respectful. If it starts getting into slinging insults or just saying offensive things that are your opinion, I'm gonna just block those comments and delete them because I don't allow that in my space and on my page. But I would love to hear professional, good conversation down below about it. And if you're interested in becoming CRNA, make sure head over to the memberships on the channel. And I offer mock interviews and I'll give you a little graphic here to show you. If you want that, email me at boltcrna@gmail.com and we can set up mock interviews to help you get into CRNA school, strategy sessions, all that kind of stuff. If you have not hit the like button, what the heck are you doing? Hit that like button, hit that subscribe button, and come back next week. Every Monday I post. That's Bolt Out.